Thank you, Mr. Secretary, for joining us here today. I want to follow up on a colleague's previous question about industrial hemp. I've spoken to a number of farmers and also textile manufacturers who are pretty excited about the opportunities for industrial hemp in Pennsylvania. And my understanding is that for the past 2 years, the department has been administering a pilot program. So can you tell us what have been the results of the pilot program to date?
Yeah, so we've done it for 2 years, 2017 and 18. I'd say that the results are, there's a broad spectrum of things, right? So some of the research focused on simply the agronomic side. How do you grow this plant, right? And then we had to sort of establish even the fundamentals of growing that crop in Pennsylvania. On the other end of the spectrum is looking at the uses of product, and some have been around the fibers and the uses of fibers, and the work that Lehigh and Jefferson Universities are doing about advanced manufacturing have looked at that. But it's everything in between. The results have been positive, but it's only been 2 years, right? I'd say every grower had a different experience over those 2 years. The consistency, part of it's weather. You know, when you take the production of industrial hemp and what would normally, you know, be in a normal year, 42 years of annual rainfall, and you get 80. I think folks had the experience this year of just simply being drowned out. But I would say it's all positive, but it's going to take some continued work by our current permits, permit holders to continue to explore that. But we're encouraged by what we have seen in the diversity of research, the diversity of that research community around industrial hemp and what they've seen. It's from, you know, the connectivity of the product. It's the advanced manufacturing. It's the food and cosmetic. So all of that's in this space around what we've learned in the last 2 years and what we're seeing, by the way, in the applications for this year.
So can you talk a little bit more about, through the pilot program, what are the most promising uses for hemp in Pennsylvania? And can you talk a little bit about advanced manufacturing possibilities?
Yeah, so I think the, you know, there are, you know, a couple of things that, just given the crop, that I think it lends itself in on the fiber side, depending on when you harvest that, the fiber is still, you know, making full use of that plant. So that could be both in the traditional sense of you know, the herd that you know, is the center part of that, and you know, from you know, traditional uses of the rope, and I always use the example of my car. You know, there is industrial hemp in the dashboard and the sidewalls. Right, that's manufacturing. That's been treated, but that's all industrial hemp. It comes from China and Canada, right? Why not the United States? So on the advanced side is, you know, the group of researchers were looking at the advanced manufacturing for clothing fiber, and you know, we're doing yoga pants, right, on these fibers. Now, if you told me that a year ago that that's even a possibility, I'd say no way, but they have figured it out. Right, that fiber lends itself to, you know, clothing and advanced. So I think all of that is possible in what we're seeing in the research.
And my understanding is that there's 84 already approved applicants for the industrial hemp program. What can you tell us about these applicants? Are they large farmers, small farmers? Is it concentrated in one region of the Commonwealth or spread across the Commonwealth?
Yeah, so and I divide this out by federal farm bill and post federal farm bill. Prior to the changes in December, the federal farm bill, we had 83 applicants and they've been approved. We've opened it back up as a result of the federal farm bill giving us the authority and removing that Schedule I drug classification. They are everywhere. They're all sizes. They're all shapes. They're all, you know, that full spectrum of product and their interests, from food to oils to you know, fiber and animal feed. So it's all in that same space. But they're the Amish, you know, doing some things who like the hand labor of that. It looks a lot like tobacco, and they can employ their families to do that. We've got folks who are doing it under glass. Because they're looking at certain parts of that plant for a product. So it's all of that.
Thank you. And this is an industry that has been opened up because there's been a change in federal policy and state policy. So it's essentially a new industry in Pennsylvania, even though it's not a new crop for us, right? Industrial hemp used to be popular in Pennsylvania. Is there anything you can tell us about what you think is possible with this industry moving forward? What does it look like in 10 years? What's your vision?
Yeah, my vision is that it is, it's part of the crop mix and diversification and rotation. You know, I think one of the areas that has great potential is the environmental remediation of hemp and being able to use it both for its environmental benefits and being able to harvest it for, the extended fiber oil seed. We are desperately searching for ways to absorb nutrients, particularly nitrogen, right, in the Chesapeake Bay watershed. So if this lends itself to answering part of that, it will be a success just for that reason, right? That's the vision. I think it has great potential for PA to be, integrated as part of the culture of agriculture in Pennsylvania. And would love to see it be restored to what we saw and the acceptance and the diversification of it as we had in the 1940s and 50s.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Thanks.